नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस एपिसोड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट ए टाइपिंग मिस्टेक दैट आई मेड इन द प्रीवियस एपिसोड, दैट इज 38th एपिसोड. इफ यू रेफर बैक टू द एपिसोड यू विल फाइंड दैट आई टॉक्ड अबाउट ए मास अटैच्ड टू ए स्ट्रिंग एंड रिवॉल्विंग इन ए सर्कल. इन द डायग्राम रिलेटेड विद इट आई कंसिडर्ड ए बॉडी of mass m kg moving with angular speed of omega radians per second at a radius of r meter about center of rotation O. The centripetal acceleration is equal to omega square r and corresponding force F is equal to m omega square r newton. If angular speed omega radians per second is equivalent to n rpm, then F is equal to m into 4 pi square n square divided by 60 square into r as shown here. I told you F is equal to m into 4 pi square n square divided by 60 and not 60 square into R, because that was typed by mistake in slide. Next step was correct. As you can see here, F is equal to mRn square divided by 91.1. Therefore, the correct expression has 60 square in denominator as shown. This was about previous episode. I regret because it might have caused confusion in your minds. I have corrected myself and so you should. Now I begin discussion on topics to be taken up in this episode. In previous episode, I talked about primary and secondary forces and vibrations due to these forces. These vibrations are to be minimized for comfortable and safe ride in an automobile. As you know now that these vibrations are reduced by using counterweights in the crankshaft. These counterweights are opposite to the crank pin. The following diagram will help you in visualizing the shape of counterweights. Let us have a look at it. It displays a portion of crankshaft. Main journal is located in the center. Crank pin is located on the upper side. Big end of connecting rod is also partially visible. The position of crank pin indicates that piston is at TDC. The counterweight has weight equal to that of crank pin assembly. The center of counterweight should be exactly opposite to the crank pin. Its distance from main journal should be same as distance between center of crank pin and center of main journal. Design engineer can decide about it depending upon space available and other factors. He can increase distance and reduce weight, or reduce distance and increase weight. This way he can keep product of weight and distance constant, which is desired condition. I mentioned it in previous episode. The decision of design engineer depends upon space available. The counterweight has certain shape. The distance between its center of gravity and center of main journal is taken into account. The counterweight may have shape as shown. You may notice that distance between center of counterweight O double dash and center of main journal O dash is small as compared to distance between center of main journal O dash and center of crank pin O. This is because counterweight is heavy as compared to crank pin big end assembly. If you refer books you will find counterweights of different shapes. The shape of counterweights also depends upon space available. As already mentioned in previous episode, crankshaft also experiences torsional vibrations in addition to vibrations due to primary and secondary forces. It also experiences winding and unwinding as it rotates. These vibrations can be dangerous if resonance occurs. This has been explained in previous episode. Occurrence of resonance is avoided through proper designing. Further, these vibrations can be reduced by using flywheel, vibration dampers, and balance shaft. Flywheel. Flywheel, as it starts, keeps rotating because of inertia. It is mounted on one end of crankshaft. Flywheel inertia provides consistent force. This consistent force helps in smooth rotation of crankshaft between firing strokes. This also helps in overcoming the impulses due to combustion in cylinder. As we know, winding and unwinding of shaft also produces vibrations. These vibrations are also reduced by this consistent force provided by flywheel inertia. This makes the overall running of engine smooth. Vibration dampers. Vibration dampers help in reducing the torsional vibrations. There are a large number of variants of vibration dampers that are available. Here, I intend to talk about three variants. First is Lanchester vibration damper. It dampens vibrations due to winding and unwinding of shaft along with torsional vibrations. Referring to diagram, the view has upper half in section to show the inner details. Plate B is mounted on crankshaft. Crankshaft experiences torsional vibrations and vibrations due to winding and unwinding. These are transmitted to plate B. Next, these tend to transmit to heavy rim R on left hand side. The vibrations are made to pass through friction material. This friction material is located between plate B and rim R, and also between plate B and pressure plate P as shown. Pressure plate is provided with springs, as can be seen on right hand side. The amount of friction can be adjusted with the help of these springs. Friction material acts as dampener and does not allow transmission of vibrations to rim R. Rim R is connected to flywheel FW. Therefore, flywheel FW 2 does not receive any vibrations. The springs are uniformly placed and their number depends upon the size of damper. Another variant of vibration dampers is known as harmonic balancer. It uses rubber to absorb vibrations. It has a rubber ring that replaces the friction material used in previous damper. Referring to diagram, balancer is mounted at the end of crankshaft as shown. It has hub H, an inertia ring IR, and pulley. The two are mounted on hub as shown. In between, there is a rubber ring visible on upper side that has been sectioned. In section view, it is visible as rectangle because it has rectangular cross section. Balancer rotates with shaft. Vibrations produced in crankshaft are transmitted to hub of balancer. Rubber ring absorbs vibrations and prevents their transmission to pulley. Inertia ring tends to maintain steady motion. This also helps in absorbing the vibrations. A modified and improved version of harmonic balancer uses viscous fluid instead of rubber. Referring to diagram, this is a viscous type damper using silicone fluid. As usual, it is mounted at the end of crankshaft. It has body with space to accommodate inertia ring as shown. The diagram shown has upper half in section to give inner details. Inertia ring I is placed inside this space and is surrounded by a thin layer of silicone fluid as shown. As crankshaft rotates, body of damper rotates with it and oscillates due to vibrations. Inertia ring I tends to maintain a steady motion. This creates considerable viscous drag in fluid. The energy produced due to vibrations is converted into heat. This heat is suitably dissipated. This type of damper is quite expensive as compared to harmonic balancer, but at the same time it is highly reliable also. Balance shaft. This is yet another component that can be added to engine assembly to reduce crankshaft vibrations. It is a shaft, as the name indicates. It is mirror image of crankshaft. To understand it in a better way, let us refer to diagram. The diagram shows crankshaft on lower side and balance shaft on upper side. Other parts of the engine have not been shown intentionally to simplify the diagram. The arrangement shown is for four-cylinder inline engine. Rotary motion of crankshaft is transferred to balance shaft with the help of chain drive. The sprocket S1 is mounted on crankshaft and sprocket S2 is mounted on a shaft that has not been shown. Sprocket S2 is integrated with gear wheel G1 on left. Gear wheel G1 meshes with gear wheel G2 mounted on balance shaft. On right, another view shows details of chain drive and gear wheels. Crankshaft rotates in clockwise direction and so the sprocket S1. The motion is transferred to sprocket S2. Sprocket S2 and gear wheel G1 rotate in clockwise direction. The rotary motion is transferred to gear wheel G2. G2 rotates in anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, the balance shaft also rotates in anti-clockwise direction. This arrangement makes possible rotation of crankshaft and balance shaft in opposite directions. Balance shaft has counterweights shown as CW1, CW2, CW3 and CW4. These counterweights are mirror image of crank pins CP1, CP2, CP3 and CP4 on crankshaft. This means that counterweights are located on the axis of balance shaft in the same way as crank pins are located on the axis of crankshaft. It may also be noticed that counterweight CW1 is downwards, whereas crank pin CP1 is upwards. Only then these form mirror image. The same is true for other counterweights and crank pins as shown in the diagram. As two shafts rotate, these produce vibrations. Because their direction of rotation is opposite to each other, therefore these vibrations are nullified. it is very important that balance shaft is timed to crankshaft. This means that throw and crank pin in crankshaft and counterweight in balance shaft are opposite to each other, as already explained and shown. If the two are not timed, the vibrations produced by them would be added up. It will produce vibrations of added amplitude that will further imbalance the engine. Therefore, it is essential that both shafts are timed. Some engines have two balance shafts instead of one. These and crankshaft together form V. These help in further improving the engine performance. I have described few methods to reduce vibrations in crankshaft. These vibrations add to the vibrations produced by engine. As far as automobiles are concerned, the vibrations are transmitted from engine to body of vehicle. These are highly uncomfortable for passengers. In goods carrying vehicles also, these are undesirable. The vibrations produced and transmitted to the body of the vehicle may damage the goods being carried. Therefore, these should be brought to minimum in all vehicles. Different manufacturers, in order to improve their product, are working continuously in this direction. All these efforts have a single aim: to make the journey of user safe and comfortable. Here I conclude discussion on dampening of vibrations in crankshaft. Thanks for watching the episode.